Welcome to the iRule Quick Start Guide. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to build a one-room universal remote control. This guide isn't meant to make you an expert in iRule. There's several advanced features to the system, which we'll get to in future tutorials. This lesson is intended to get you started and lay the foundation for making your customized remote control. The first thing I'm going to do is walk through the builder interface, do a brief explanation, build our remote control, and finally show you how to save, backup, and sync the file to your handheld device. What you're looking at now is the iRule Builder. On the far left side is the Panels window. This is where you'll find all the features of the remote control. It's also where you can see pages with the graphical interface and each component of your remote control. Now right underneath that is the Properties tab. Anything that needs editing, such as the name of a button, what panel a link references, anything like that, is all changed down here in the Properties tab. Now over in the main window is where you'll find your actual remote control, as well as the summary of each of the panels that you click on. Whatever you click on will be shown right here in the main window. On the right hand side of your screen is the Actions window. This is where you'll find tabs for your images, devices, feedbacks, and other options that we have available through iRule. Each item under the More tab will be explained in a future tutorial. Alright, now that's the layout of the iRule Builder. Let's get started building our remote. The first thing that we need to do is tell iRule what device we'll be using as a remote. Click File on the top left-hand side of your screen and choose New Handset. From here, choose your device in the Dropbox. For this tutorial, we'll use the iPhone or iPod option near the top. Below that is your template. Basically what style you want your remote to look like. For this demonstration, we're going to use brushed. Go ahead and click Add. Next, you want to add which devices you want your remote to control. Go up to the Devices tab and choose Browse Devices. We'll start by adding a Panasonic Blu-ray player. So under the Type tab, search Blu-ray, and then search Panasonic under Vendor. Now with iRule, you don't need a model number, so go ahead and hit search. Select the device, hit import, and then you can see at the bottom we have one imported device. So now let's go back to the dropdown and add a Sony CD player. Choose CD as your type and search Sony as your vendor. Choose the device that best matches your CD player and go ahead and import. Now at the bottom you'll see we have two devices, so we're going to go ahead and add our receiver. Search Receiver Preamp, and let's use Integra for this demonstration. Go ahead and search. Now you'll see we have a lot of options here. So first we want to look at the codes near the right hand side. Choose the device based on how you'll control it. There's IP, RS-232, and IR. For this demonstration we'll use IP. Choose the device that best matches yours, and import. Time to add our DirecTV. Choose Satellite as your type, and type DirecTV in your vendor browser. Choose your device and import. Now we're almost there, time to add our TV. Search TV under type, and let's look up a Panasonic. Now for this we're going to go ahead and choose All Models, and then import. You'll see at the bottom we've imported 5 devices, so from here let's hit Close. Now in the Devices tab, you'll see some generic placeholders up at the top, and the 5 new devices that we just added down at the bottom. So we want to replace all those placeholder templates with our actual devices. So right click up top on Templates, Replace Device With, and then find the device that you'll be replacing it with. Right click on Template CD, Replace Device With, find our CD player, Preview. And here you can see iRule will replace a few of our total commands. That's fine. Go ahead and hit import. Now, do the same thing for all of your remaining devices. Now, you can see all of our devices are in the center screen. So from here, we can go ahead and clean up our workspace by deleting our template devices. You go up, right click, and delete template devices. From here, let's take a look at our homepage. Go to the Panels window, open Main, then click Home. Here we go. If you hover over an icon, you can see that we pre-built the macros for you. But you'll notice that they're only the power macros. You'll need to add the specific macros for your personal devices. It's no big deal. Go back to Devices and open our Integra receiver under the Actions tab. Then, open Network Codes. Once we drag the receiver input commands onto the macro, we'll be 90% done with our remote control. Scroll down until you find inputs, and we'll click and drag these codes onto our home screen. Take input cable SAT, which will be our DirecTV, then DVD, which will be our Blu-ray player, use AUX1 for Apple TV, CD for our CD player, and our Game TV for the Roku player. Okay, we're almost done, but we need to copy these commands in one more place. So go back to the Panels window, scroll down to Drawers, and click Property Pages. Again, drag input cable SAT to DirecTV, CD to the music player, input AUX over Apple TV, and DVD over the Blu-ray player. If at any time you want to see what a button does, simply hold your cursor over it and you can see exactly what the macro does in this yellow box. Now let's minimize drawers and check our devices by opening Watch Movie and clicking Portrait Page. You'll notice that the Panasonic Blu-ray menu button is darkened in. That means that there's no code entered for the menu. To fix this, go to your Devices tab again on the right-hand side of your screen and open the Blu-ray tab. Click Database Codes, scroll down to Main Menu, and drag the code over. Check the other portrait pages to make sure all the buttons are working, and looks like they are. Now let's go to Watch TV. Again, portrait pages. You'll see that there's no code for the live button. That's because DirecTV doesn't have a live button. So instead, we're going to go ahead and add the skip button in its place. Once you find the skip button, just go ahead and drag that over. All right, all of your codes are entered, so now we can save, backup, and sync. Go up to File, hit Save, and that will save your remote to your account in the cloud. Now, after it saves, you'll want to create a backup, so in the future, if you have a similar project, you can simply restore it, and instead of creating a whole new remote control, you can upload this setup into a customer's account. From there, you can make a few changes, but you're basically done. This step won't only save you time, but it'll save you money. All right, now that it's saved, we'll go back to File, hit Backup, and you're gonna save the downloaded file in a folder on your computer, somewhere where you can access it later. Now that it's saved, I'll show you how to sync the remote control to your handheld device. Open the app on your iPhone and log in. This is an account that you set up when you're creating your customer account. After you have your username and your password typed in, go ahead and hit Sync. Now this is going to show you your available devices. If you're creating an iPhone, iPad, or Android device, the app will only display the option that's relevant to your device. We're not going to show you an iPad because an iPad won't fit on the iPhone screen. So go ahead and hit iPhone, and this is going to synchronize everything. Okay, that's complete. Next thing we want to do is set up our gateways. Since we selected source codes for IR, we'll click on the plus for iTouch IR. And it's going to find all of the global cache gateways on our network. So here's our IR gateway. We're going to click onto it. Now we'll assign our IR devices. We'll assign our Panasonic TV to IR number 1. Our Panasonic Blu-ray player to IR number 2, And finally, our Sony CD player to IR number 3. Now, we'll rename the gateway to test our system. You can label it whatever you'd like, just so you remember it. Hit save, and that will auto-populate to replace our gateway. Now we can go down into our network to configure our Integra receiver. You'll need to know the IP address, and we recommend using static IP addresses. In this case, I'll enter 112, our port number, and all this information is available on our support page online under compatible devices. Okay, label that Integra, save that. Add a new one for HTTP for our DirecTV box. Type in another IP address. And that's gonna be port 8080. Now, we don't need any passwords or anything like that. So change this to DirecTV. Now you can label it DirecTV, or if you have multiples, DirecTV 1, 2, or even the rooms, anything that helps you remember it. Finally, I'm gonna go into panels, start at our main, and now we can actually use our remote control. As you can see, we have our DVR, so we are on our DirecTV. Here is our page of favorites over to the right. This is anything that you can customize if you'd like. And now I'll show you the drawers. Basically, you can slide out to the right, have your volume. You can slide to the left. And then we have our bottom drawer, which will take you home or to the power page, or lighting, or even help. Under the main, you can open Blu-ray, or if we want to go to Apple TV, we can also open our Apple TV. Now, the drawers on your homepage allow extra function as far as more real estate on a small handset such as an iPhone. This concludes our startup guide. If you need any help at all, please click on the support tab or visit us at iruleathome.com and click support. We're there 24/7 for you.